Hello all, I'm Glenn Fox, and in this video I'll discuss the biliary tract. My objectives for this video are for you to understand the drainage pattern of bile and the structure of the gallbladder. Bile is produced in the liver, and that bile is drained from the liver through the hepatic ducts. There's a right and a left hepatic duct. These hepatic ducts unite to form the common hepatic duct, which can conduct bile down to the cystic duct, where it can be stored for later release by the gallbladder. A continuation of the junction of common hepatic duct and the cystic duct is known as the bile duct or the common bile duct, which descends down in the hepatoduodenal ligament and is joined by the pancreatic duct to form this dilation called the hepatopancreatic ampulla. That hepatopancreatic ampulla moves through the major duodenal papilla, where these secretions are released into the second or descending part of the duodenum. Shown here are the contents of the hepatoduodenal ligament. Keeping in mind that hepatoduodenal ligament is going to connect the liver adjacent to the gallbladder with the duodenum. And the three major constituents of this hepatoduodenal ligament are the bile duct, or the common bile duct, the hepatic artery proper, HAP, which then divides into the left and the right branches of the hepatic artery proper, as well as the hepatic portal vein, which is draining all of the blood from the gastrointestinal tract and delivering it to the liver for processing. The gallbladder sits in close association with the right anatomical lobe of the liver, and it can be found inferior to this right lobe. The gallbladder's role is to store bile conducted through the common hepatic duct and cystic duct from the liver, which is why oftentimes the gallbladder in cadaveric specimens is stained green. The gallbladder has a fundus, although in anatomical position that fundus is inferior, a body, and a neck. And it's supplied by the cystic artery. The cystic artery is typically a branch of the right branch of the hepatic artery proper. It may also be a branch of the hepatic artery proper, or a branch of the gastroduodenal artery, or may find its source from a variety of other vessels. That cystic artery is a very important artery to locate for the removal of the gallbladder, and it can reliably be found in the hepatobiliary triangle. That hepatobiliary triangle has the following sides. The superior portion, or side, is going to be the inferior surface of the liver. The medial portion is the common hepatic duct. And the inferior portion, running alongside of the gallbladder, is going to be the cystic duct. And so we can see that that cystic artery, regardless of its vessel of origination, is going to traverse that hepatobiliary triangle. In terms of its innervation, the gallbladder is innervated by the hepatic plexus. Thank you for your time. If you have any questions or a need in further visuals, please do visit the BlueLink website. Thank you.